to Taco for this song. I have said it many a times. I gotta hear every last second of this song. Oh. Yes, that is Daley, alone, together. But I'm not alone today. I am actually here and have the pleasure to meet the man, yes, I said the man, who sings that song, with Marsha Ambrosius. I actually had Marsha in here, and she talked about that song, and she talked about you, and how incredible your voice is, Daley. So welcome to the Tammi Mac Show. Thank you so much for being here today.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
I'm hot. You got me sweating up in here.
Yeah, you were working. You were working to that one.
I really, like, that is one of my favorite songs. And it was how I was introduced to you, because I didn't know you prior to that.
Right.
And I didn't know of your music prior to that, I should say.
Yeah.
And the first thought that came to my mind when I Googled and saw the video and was Simply Red. Do you remember an artist named Simply Red?
Yeah, definitely. He's from the same. We're from the same town.
Yeah, the UK.
Yeah, well, from Manchester. Yeah, the city that we're from. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So you're from the same city.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And I immediately thought Simply Red, and I wondered, like, what were you ever familiar with him, his music? Did you know him, or do you see any similarities between, other than you're both redheads and white?
Yeah, those tend to be the two main ones, and you know, and we both have a leaning towards the soulful, you know, the soulful vibe.
Yeah.
But no, I mean, he's obviously kind of the previous musical generation, I would say, to me, or maybe a couple before me. But yeah, he's, you know, I definitely grew up around Simply Red music, you know, the I guess the 90s, was it? Early 90s?
Yeah, it was early 90s, almost late 80s, yeah, early 90s, yeah.
So, I mean, I was definitely aware. And then when I first came out in my career, you know, it was kind of like, the new Simply Red, you know?
So everybody did say that. They gave you that whole tag.
Yeah, there was a phase. But then I think, you know, I think as I went on and did my own thing, it was like, okay, not quite the new Simply Red, but, you know.
I'm Daley.
I'm Daley, yeah. But, you know, so he made some great music, so.
And so when we first started playing this song, and I hate to ask like the same boring questions, but the people who've interviewed you that don't have my listeners.
Right.
And so when I first played this song, no one believed me when I said it was a man singing the song. Your falsetto is impeccable.
Thank you so much.
Impeccable. And we were talking about just yesterday how there aren't very many falsettos today that sing, number one, like you do, but that even incorporate that into their music. Eric Benet does that really well.
He does it very, very well.
And we were going down the list yesterday, my program director and I, and he was like, the stylistics, and that, like, we had to go way back to figure it out.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Do you have registers other than the falsetto?
Yeah, and it's funny, I was talking to somebody about this last week at radio, who was saying that, because I did like a little live session thing last week, and the person who I was interviewing said, I didn't know you could do lower,
the deeper ranges.
And I was like, you know what, I didn't for a while. I mean, I did, but it was, you know, people always sort of talked about my falsetto, and I think I just ran with it. But now, you know, doing touring and performing to people, you kind of see people react to, I've heard people reacting to me doing other things with my voice. So now I'm just like, you know what? It's anything goes.
Layla Hathaway. I had Layla Hathaway in here. She does this incredible, I'm sure you know Layla Hathaway.
Oh, yeah.
Hathaway. Right, you heard her before. She has this thing she does with her voice where she hits like three different notes at one time.
The chord polyphonic.
So there's a name for that?
I mean, I don't know if that's the name for it, but I guess polyphonic, you know, being able to make multiple notes or chords with, you know, your voice, which is crazy.
It sounds like, but your voice sounds like that's something you could do. Do you have that talent, that skill?
I don't. It actually baffles me. I don't know how that works. I mean, it's kind of crazy, but it's an amazing thing to watch. If she can teach me, Layla.
Layla, if you're out there, holla at us, Layla, holla at us. You've got a new single out. It's called Second to None.
Yes.
And we've been banging it.
I appreciate
and,
that. Thank
it's
you.
Another one that I love.
Yeah, you like it?
Yeah. And okay, so I'm feeling all of your nice ballads, but when you gonna break out of that shell and pop a funky one on us, Daley?
Well, I mean, there was a really funky one on this album, The Spectrum, the one that I'm kind of just at the tail end of right now, called Sympathy, mm-hmm. which you might, it didn't kind of get released as a single, but you should definitely check it out if you want to hear a little funk or a little
okay, I do want, vibe. I definitely want to check it out. Yeah. It's your second album,
yes.
The Spectrum.
Yeah.
And what can you say about The Spectrum? What does that mean? Like a spectrum of voices, a spectrum of ideas, a spectrum mm-hmm. of music? What does that mean?
Well, it was something that kind of just, it was a word that kept appearing to me throughout the process of making the album. And I kind of, when things like that happen, I usually write them down. I have like a little notepad or something that I just write down words or things that could, that I feel like could become something, you know, like words, mm-hmm. phrases, song titles. And I just kind of had it with a pin just there. And then I carried on writing the album, and I started making this album, I think I had a bit of pressure and a bit of an expectation of what I thought it was supposed to be like, you know, mm-hmm. trying to fit in with a certain kind of sound or a certain kind of trend of a sound. And I think I started off making the album in that mindset, but as I went on, I was like, satisfying me. You know, I felt like I was leaving out so much of what I wanted to do, and different types of different feelings, different emotions, different sounds. So at one point in the process, I was like, you know what? I just have to do whatever feels right to do. So I kind of just broke out and didn't deny myself any part of the musical spectrum that I wanted to create with the album. Right. So that was when the word, I was like, that's it. That's the word. It's spectrum. The spectrum, you know? And it means a lot of things, you know, and I think it filters into a lot of areas of life, and the idea of just in general to not put things in boxes, because,
right.
you know, that you limit yourself if you do that. So that was kind of what the spectrum is.
Absolutely. So if you're just tuning in, I'm talking to Daley. The new album is The Spectrum, and the single we're playing is Second to None. I'm going to play it in a minute. I don't mean to get too controversial, but Tyrese... has come into the station a lot. He comes in because he has a lot to say.
Right.
And one thing that he talks about frequently is how black artists have songs that could potentially be crossover songs that white or mainstream radio won't play.
Yeah.
And he oftentimes mentions Sam Smith and how, you know, mainstream radio will play Sam Smith but won't play a Tyrese song or a Tank song. And so I wonder what your experience is with that, being white doing R&B or soul music. Like, does mainstream radio show you love, Daley?
I mean, honestly, I mean, I would think I would be naive to say that there's no influence of that within the music industry or within America. You know, there's always, unfortunately, a hint of it. But I would say, I mean, I'm not Sam Smith, and I don't feel, and I haven't ascended
to his heights.
Yeah. So I can't say personally that I've experienced that thing of like, I'm white and they're playing my music everywhere, because I feel like I'm kind of in the, you know, I'm putting the work in and doing things the way that I would like to do it, which is the not that Sam Smith's not genuine, but I just mean I'm doing it the, what's the word? The
your way.
The grassroots way. Yeah, my way. So
the Frank Sinatra, you're doing it your way.
Right. And, you know, and I'm in, I guess you might want to call it, in the trenches with all my contemporaries who definitely many of them are African-American. And I would like to feel that I'm in the trenches with the artists, with the R&B artists, and mm-hmm. being an R&B artist myself. So I do think it would be naive to say that there's absolutely no kind of, what's the word? Like
bias.
Novelty value in me being a white artist singing R&B. I've definitely experienced people, like even like you were saying, when they hear the song and then they're like, that's a white guy, you know?
Right.
There is an element of that, but I just try and keep it focused on the music and I'm just trying to keep, you know, be genuine and true to the music and do it in the right way. So,
but do they play Alone Together, Second to None? Do they play that on mainstream radio? Are you getting mainstream spins?
Not that I know of. You guys are the ones who are supporting it.
We're showing you love because we're radio free.
Yeah, and I truly, truly appreciate it. And the same when you come to my shows, you know, it's not a quote unquote mainstream audience. You know, I mean.
It's an eclectic group of people.
Well, it's eclectic, but also, you know, there's no doubt that, you know, black audiences in America and all around the world, in the UK, in Europe, have always been the audiences that have kind of taken my music to heart and been the foundation of my fan base. So I definitely appreciate, and I'm very, very honored not being from here, you know, to have that connection with people.
Do you feel like people outside of the States have more of a respect for music than the United States? I feel like when artists who are really deep into their craft go abroad, they get major love. But it's so difficult in America to get that same thing if you're not, quote, commercial, whatever that means.
Yeah, it's...
But you're from the UK, so you know what the audience reaction is to music in general.
Yeah.
So it's like you guys have a different love for music, a different affection towards music. Is that true? Or
I don't know if I would say music in general. I mean, if you want to maybe specifically talk about kind of R&B and soul, it's kind of like everything has its pros and cons, because the thing I love about America is America knows soul music. America knows R&B. It's the birthplace of R&B and soul. So when I come and perform here, I do feel that with the audiences. I feel that they get me, you know, in a way that in Europe there isn't, you know, there isn't the same thing. But in Europe there's a different thing where it's kind of hard to describe, but they do, like, in Europe, American soul artists are very, very highly regarded, whereas British soul artists always necessarily aren't. So a lot of, like, British soul R&B artists don't get, in the UK, don't get as much love. Like, for me, you know, personally, I found a lot of my audience over here in the States. So I spend a lot of time here now. And I guess I wouldn't want to say that the UK, you know, doesn't support, but there's more support here for me, for sure. And so I think there's also an element of, like, wherever you're not from, that's where they appreciate you, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
There's an element of that.
I go home to Houston and nobody gives a damn.
Right.
I come to LA and they're like, hey, Tammi.
Yeah, so I don't know what that's about, but I think it's definitely the different parts of the world have different appreciations for the same music, and there's no science to it really. I think it's all to do with the journey that you've taken as an artist, how much, you know, how much of a role the record label had, how much of a role you know, how exposed you've been, all that kind of stuff. So,
all right. Well, we're going to continue to talk to Daley because he's got the new sophomore album out, The Spectrum, and the song is second to none. We're playing it, and a few of you have requested it. We just started playing it about a couple of weeks ago, I would say.
Amazing.
So people are calling about it, but I got to let them know who it is and that it's hot, and then they're like, oh, yeah, I heard it this time, Tammi Mac. So we're going to come back, play second to